Hey guys, I'm Jeevan Patel. Thanks, Sujit, for the introduction. So Sujit and I usually tag team on multiple different topics. In this particular conversation, we'd like to bring up the topic of the Apple Bonjour. And of course, in this topic, we're going to talk specifically about Apple. But you know, as you guys are familiar, the whole BYOD is a pretty broad topic. You know, it started with Apple, and over a period of time, it may also extend to sort of non-Apple devices, and you know, you can even expect, you know, some other sort of protocols like DLNA and such to also become interesting. So what I have with me is Sudhir sitting in the back. So keep your questions coming. So we'll keep coding as we are going on. So keep your questions coming in and keep us, you know, conversational. And Damodar will, of course, do a fantastic demo after my slides. So first and foremost, I've got some slides that kind of are going to describe the problem. So let's quickly go through this. So first and foremost, if you guys, if there's anybody out there who doesn't know what is Bonjour, or you know, I doubt, but you know, I could be one of those guys who sit in the back and too afraid to ask. So I just wanted to kind of describe that. So Bonjour is essentially Apple's service discovery protocol, which means if you bought some sort of a Apple printer, or if you're doing AirPlay, in that case, Bonjour is a protocol that's actually used to advertise those particular services. So what is this specific problem, or who's coming up with a request for this? It's essentially the K-12 or the education customers, you know, higher education customers coming and saying, you know, I've got a teacher who wants to look cool in front of the students, right? So he's going to carry my iPad, so he's going to walk inside the classroom. He wants to mirror the image of the iPad onto the Apple TV in the classroom. So how do I do that? So that's essentially the one way. And of course, the you know, what's also relevant or also tied into that is essentially guest. I mean, so if the student walks in at the same time, you know, can you make sure that the student cannot project anything on that same Apple TV, right? We don't want to necessarily see what the students are seeing in the classroom, right? So that's of course the policy tie into that. So that's essentially describing what is the Bonjour problem. But even more specifically, as we've seen, Bonjour is all about easy setup. It was focused with sort of home environment in mind. You know, when you look at, you know, putting Apple devices such as, you know, anything from a phone, laptop, you know, from a printer, essentially, and doing all these services in a K-12, in an education environment, or even some enterprise environments, when you start going across a layer 3 boundary, what really happens? So that's essentially the key problem that we are here to talk about and solve. And before I jump into this, you know, there have been certain, let's just say, certain set of customers that want to solve this problem, that want essentially Apple to solve this problem, right? So, you know, what we want to do is, we don't want to take a religious position here. We're just going to here come in and say, if you're a customer that wants Apple to solve this problem and doesn't want to use sort of Bonjour across layer 3, then, you know, so be it. But if you're a customer that wants to take advantage of this, then here is a solution for you, all right? So just to be clear there. So let's kind of describe this in a little bit more detail. So what this slide really shows you is, if you are across a VLAN or across a layer 3 network, and you're actually advertising a Bonjour service on one specific VLAN, the other VLAN cannot actually access it, right? So in a school environment, you typically cross over a layer 2 and go into layer 3. How do you exactly solve this problem? So what I'm going to describe to you, what essentially Damodar is going to do a deep dive into this, is essentially what we intend to start a beta for pretty soon. So if any of you guys or your customers are interested in sort of signing up for testing this code, let us know. Of course, you know, keep your comments coming. We've got Sudhir sitting in the back sort of evaluating what to do next. So clearly keep your questions coming. So with that, let me hand it over to Damodar.
So what I want you guys to get out of this slide is, as you know, Bonjour is linked local multicast, right? So anything coming to the router is going to be dropped. So there are no multicast packets that are going to be routed from VLAN X to VLAN Y. But in a typical deployment, or in a huge deployment, you want your services to scale, like scale across VLANs, scale across subnets, be available on the entire network. And that is where the Cisco, like basically the Bonjour gateway comes into play. Like for the Bonjour protocol, what happens is every Apple TV or every Air printer that comes on a network sends a Bonjour service record. Now this service record is sent over a multicast, like a VLAN, local VLAN. And what the controller over here does is the controller actually caches all these entries. So like you see over here, we have a wired printer and an Apple TV over a wireless network. And both these services are going to go to the controller. Then the controller is going to cache it. And now the controller knows, OK, there is an Apple TV on VLAN 20 and an Air printer on VLAN 23. And it recognizes and it knows all these services. Now, let's say an iPad, which is on VLAN 99, comes on a network. And it sends a text record, not a text, actually, a Bonjour pointer record asking for what are the services offered. Now, the bad thing is there are no services on VLAN 99. But the good thing is the controller knows about the services that are there on the overall network, right? So the controller is going to say, okay, there is an AirPlay which is available on VLAN 20. So you can access this service. And once the iPad knows, okay, what's the VLAN, and it can actually resolve this by getting the IP address. And once it knows the IP address, it can get or it can make use of this service across VLANs. So that's essentially the goal of the gateway, where the controller acts as a services directory. So with that, I'm just going to show a small demo before I dive into policies and what are the additional things that we do on top of just enabling services across subnets. Right? So I think it's on one. Yeah. So that's the Apple TV that we have. Let me just show you the IP address of the Apple TV. So it's on the 10.10.20 network. So it's like a VLAN 20. It's a completely different subnet. And now this is the Apple TV. Now this is the iPad. So let's look at the option for. So it's on the 10. So it's on VLAN 10, basically a completely different subnet from the Apple TV. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to basically preview, use the Apple TV for the presentation from now on. And I'm going to switch this guy and show more about what we do for the services, right? So so I'm going to just go from here. All right. Cool. Yeah, so this is the controller that we have. And if you go on the controller and look at the MDNS, now this guy can actually see the Apple TV because this guy has all the interfaces that it can look at. And then you can also, at the general level, at the global config, you can actually have different services configured over here. So you can have an AirPrint, Apple TV printer, scanner. You can add your services as well. But you can say, okay, on a global level, I don't want to have the Apple TV. I don't want to see the Apple TV. All right, works fine now. All right, so we have this over here. Now, talking about policies, so let me just get on that topic, right? So what we can do right now is we can have different policies on different interfaces. You can either have it on a WLAN, you can have per VLAN or AP groups, you can have it per interface. So you can have Apple TV offered on one VLAN, say VLAN 20, versus Apple TV not being offered on VLAN 10. So that way you can differentiate between different users. Like if you have the VLAN override feature, then you can actually have the teachers on a different subnet and the students on a different one. That way you know that the students don't have access to the Apple TV, but the students do, right? This is the example of like for enterprise. If you want the employees to have access to AirPrint, AirPlay, and your file share, right? You want the employees to work, like you want easy access to file share, extract, get the files from the server, put the files back. But you don't want to do that for the guests. You just want them to display or give a presentation. That's the only access that you want to give. So you can do that with the VLAN override feature. Put them on a different VLAN, have only AirPlay configured for it, and for the employees, you can have all the different services, right? And for you can, and this is like a classic student, like classic school example, where you have teachers and students on two different networks where the students do not have access to AirPlay, do not have access to the file share, but the teachers get the entire access. That way they can show or they can project their iPads, their MacBooks, whatever they have onto the Apple TV. So I just want to go into the example, like showing how can we configure different services. So if we look at interfaces over here, and let's not look virtual, but let's have a different one where you have Apple. So over here, you can actually put different DNS profiles that you have created, and you can use that on an interface. And you can basically create an interface like actually having profile. You can say new, and just give it a name. And you can say, okay, on this one, okay, I just want AirPrint. That's it. I don't want to have anything else. Right? And that's it. So all you have is on that, in that MDNS profile, you just have AirPrint. You don't have any other services which could be configured. The same thing, you can actually do that for the WLAN as well. So you have a WLAN over here. Go to advanced MDNS snooping, and you can actually change the profile on the WLAN itself. So you have like a flexibility of doing it on a WLAN on an interface. And we're working on having it per user. That's still in the works, but we definitely have that in the future.
So right now it's not per VLAN?
So right now it's per VLAN.
VLAN,
yeah. Yeah, right now it's like interfaces is the
right.
Gateway to the VLAN, right? So you can have different policies for different VLANs.
Okay, because I have 5 VLANs and 1 SSID, I can assign.
Yeah, so you can do that, right? So like 1 VLAN for the students, 1 VLAN for the teachers, and offer different services for different, like, all right, so with that, like the next thing that I want to talk about is Bonjour. So like Bonjour Multicast. Like the thing, what used to happen before is the traffic used to be multicasted, and multicast is not a good friend over Wi-Fi. Right? It sends it over a lower data throughput, and it basically, it's a very chatty protocol. So the more APs and the more clients that you have on the network, the more RF you're going to use, because now when you send the multicast traffic, every AP is going to repeat the same traffic over the network. And what happens with this optimized Bonjour is because the controller actually caches all these entries, so it doesn't forward everything over the air. So what would happen is the controller actually maintains the services directory for all these services that are being offered. And they are basically unicasted. So if an Apple TV if an iPad comes and asks for an app for what are the services being offered, the services would be unicasted back to the iPad. It won't be sent over multicast. So for the devices that don't really need this information, you don't get it. And we just did a small test. What we did is we had...
Question, yeah. For you one. Is that stopping it at the subnet layer, so there's somebody else on the same subnet as iPad when it makes a request? The controller is still blocking that.
Yes.
As well as blocking anyone who's...
Anyone from different subnet for now, yes. So that's what happens.
So it's proxying Bonjour.
Kind of. Not really.
We're not proxying. Yeah. We're not forwarding everything everywhere, you know, across layer 3. What we're simply doing is we're listening. We are creating our own database. And if you ask for a printer, if you have the privileges to access that printer, only you will get that, not everybody else. So we are actually being extremely efficient,
yeah,
with the traffic. That's what Damodar is trying to
highlight. So let's look at this way, right? You have the controller over here, and the controller maintains a list of services. What are the Apple TVs? What are the domain names? And it maintains all this. So let's call this the services directory. Now if, let's say an iPad comes on the network and asks for the information, this information is going to go to the controller, and the controller knows, okay, I have this Apple TV over here on a different subnet, and I'm just going to unicast this information back. So what used to happen before was the iPad sends this, and it used to be multicasted to everyone, and it goes over the air for over every AP. And as the deployment increases, as you have more APs, you have more traffic being repeated. So with the optimized delivery, we are actually avoiding that, and we're just sending one packet instead of like the packet that depends on the number of APs that are there on your network. So that's precisely what we did. And what we did was 6 iPads, one Apple TV. It's all in the same subnet for this one. 2.4 gigahertz spectrum. Just have all the iPads turned on for 60 seconds. See what the traffic is. And the orange bar is basically with the MDNS snooping turned off, like without this feature. And the blue one is with this feature turned on. We see that like just for 4 APs, we see almost an 80% less MDNS traffic over the air. And as the deployment keeps increasing, we're going to see even lesser traffic being generated.
Think about auditoriums, school auditoriums. Think about stadiums.
Yeah,
right?
Think about events, right? Like WWDC or anything of that sort. I mean, where everyone uses a MacBook, and you're going to have so many requests over the air. You just want to put, we're wasting any of your spectrum.
Does this require central data switching, or can you do it on local switch IPs as well?
Central data switch.
Central switch. Yeah.
Because the right now in the architecture we have the controller which is caching all these entries, and you need the controller to respond back.
So the way you can also look at it is if you are usually in a branch environment, it's likely going to be a layer 2, and that's where you probably don't even need to worry about it. But you know, if the interest arises with a lot of customers, sure, you know, such a code can be written.
So you're saying that what you're doing today is you're broadcasting it to all of the different APs?
No, we are not broadcasting it. We will only respond back
unicast.
when a client asks for a service. If that client has the privilege, we will respond back with that specific unicast message to you. Okay. So that's basically what we're
doing. So instead, like what used to happen before is it goes and the request goes all the way to the Apple TV, and then the Apple TV responds back. In this case, since the controller is aware of the services,
so
controller.
You say before, you're meaning older code that you've got for the controller.
Yeah, in the older code. Exactly.
I'm sorry, I'm not as familiar as some of these guys.
Oh, okay. So with the older code, before this feature, right? Before this feature, we don't even go across subnets. Mm-hmm. In the same subnet, all the services or all the requests go over multicast, and they go over multicast. And when the Apple TV gets this message, it responds back over multicast. So there are like multiple traffics that are getting generated.
So before you were just rebroadcasting all the multicast.
Exactly, multicast, yeah. But right now we just cache it and then send a unicast. So we save more traffic, more RF.